Have you ever found yourself driving home from work, pulling into your driveway, and then realizing you don't remember parts of the drive? Or reaching for your phone dozens of times a day without even thinking about it? These automatic behaviors aren't just random, they're habits, and they're deeply wired into your brain. I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I make mental health education videos to help you strengthen your mind, fortify your brain, and build resilience. In our last video, we explored how mental rehearsal and visualization can prepare your brain for challenging situations. Today, we're turning to something even more fundamental, how your brain forms habits, and more importantly, how you can take control of this process to build a more resilient mind. Understanding how habits form gives you the power to reshape them. Let's start by looking at what's actually happening in your brain when a habit forms. Your brain is constantly looking for ways to save energy and be more efficient. One of the primary ways it does this is by turning repeated behaviors into automatic routines that require little to no conscious thought. This automation happens in the area of your brain called the basal ganglia, which is located deep in the center of your brain. Think of the basal ganglia as your brain's autopilot system. When you perform an action repeatedly, the basal ganglia take notice and begin to encode that behavior as an automatic routine. What's fascinating about this process is how it connects to neuroplasticity, which is your brain's ability to form new connections based on experience. Each time you repeat a behavior, you strengthen specific neural pathways, making that behavior more automatic. It's like walking the same path through a field of tall grass. Each time you take that route, the path becomes more defined and easier to follow. This process serves an important evolutionary purpose. By automating routine behaviors, your brain frees up mental resources for more important tasks. Imagine if you had to consciously think about every step involved in driving a car or brushing your teeth. You'd be mentally exhausted before your day even gets going. But how exactly does a behavior become automatic? This is where the habit loop comes in, a concept popularized by Charles Duhigg in his book, The Power of Habit. The habit loop consists of three elements, a cue, a routine, and a reward. Let me break this down. The cue is the trigger that initiates the habit. It could be a time of day, a specific location, an emotional state, the presence of certain people, or a preceding action. All of those can be cues. For example, finishing dinner might be a cue to check your phone. The routine is the behavior itself, the habit that you perform. This might be scrolling through social media, having a snack, or going on a run. The reward is what makes the habit worth repeating, and it's the payoff that tells your brain, remember this pattern, it's worth doing again. This could be the pleasure of sweet food, the endorphin rush from exercise, or the dopamine hit that you get from seeing new notifications. So let's use a common example to illustrate this. Checking your phone. The cue might be feeling a moment of boredom or hearing a notification sound. The routine is picking up the phone and checking your messages or social media. And the reward is the small hit of dopamine that you get from seeing the new information or the social connection. With each repetition of this loop, the pathway in your brain becomes stronger and the behavior becomes more automatic. Eventually, you find yourself reaching for your phone without even making a conscious decision to do so. This brings us to an important point. Your brain doesn't distinguish between good habits and bad habits. From a neurological perspective, the process is exactly the same, whether you habitually drink water throughout the day or habitually reach for a cigarette when you feel stressed. Your brain is simply trying to automate behaviors that it perceives as rewarding or beneficial in some way. This value-neutral aspect of habit formation is important because it explains why certain habits, especially those involving dopamine-rich rewards, can be so hard to break. Dopamine-rich rewards are things like sugar, social media, or substances like cigarettes. Dopamine is often called the pleasure chemical, but that's not exactly accurate. It's actually a reinforcement chemical. It's your brain's way of saying, yep, do that again. The reinforcement from dopamine is why willpower alone is not enough to change your habits. When you're trying to break a habit through sheer force of will, you're essentially pitting your prefrontal cortex, the thinking, planning part of your brain, against the powerful automatic systems of the basal ganglia. And in that contest, the basal ganglia usually wins. One of the biggest insights from habit research is that habits aren't eliminated, they're replaced. That's because your brain doesn't erase old habit loops. It just files them away in case they're needed again. This is why someone who hasn't smoked in years can suddenly feel the urge again in stressful situations. Under pressure, your brain reactivates familiar patterns. So instead of trying to quit a habit cold turkey, you need to swap it out for a better alternative, one that still gives your brain a sense of reward. For example, if you reach for your phone when you're bored, try reaching for a book instead or something else that gives you pleasure. If you snack when you're stressed, replace the snack with a deep breathing practice or perhaps sipping warm chamomile tea. If you usually check your social media first thing in the morning, start your day with journaling or a quick stretch. The key here is to keep the cue and the reward the same, changing the behavior in the middle, the routine. Now, before you can make those swaps, you need to build awareness. This means noticing your existing habits without judgment. Start by choosing one habit that you'd like to examine more closely. For the next few days, each time you engage in that behavior, pause and ask yourself, what happened right before I did this? What exactly am I doing? And what reward do I seem to be getting from it? This kind of self-inquiry helps bring the habit into conscious awareness, and that alone begins to weaken its automatic grip. You're essentially shining a spotlight on what your brain has been doing in the background. Another strategy that can work well is called habit stacking. This means linking a new habit to something that you already do consistently. For example, if you always brush your teeth in the morning, you can use that moment as a cue to do 2 minutes of deep breathing right afterward. By attaching a new behavior to an established one, you're piggybacking on the brain's existing wiring to make the new habit more likely to stick. Your environment also plays a powerful role in shaping your habits. In fact, many of our behaviors are triggered simply by what's around us. If you want to eat healthier, keep fresh food visible and easy to grab. If you want to cut back on screen time, put your phone in another room while you work. By reducing friction for the good habits and increasing friction for the ones that you want to break, you're making it easier to follow through without relying solely on discipline or grit. You can also use dopamine to your advantage. Remember, dopamine is your brain's reinforcement signal. It tells your brain, this behavior is worth it, so let's do it again. To boost that reinforcement, here are some things you can try. Pairing new habits with something that's enjoyable, like listening to music while you tidy up. Tracking your progress visually, like checking boxes off when you complete the habit. Or setting small, realistic goals that give you quick wins and help you build momentum. This is how you work with your brain instead of against it. You're not forcing change, you're rewiring patterns through repetition and reward. And the good news is, you don't need to make huge changes overnight. Small, consistent changes are far more effective than trying to overhaul your whole life at once. Habits are built through repetition, not intensity. In our next video, we'll dive deeper into why bad habits are so sticky and what to do when you feel stuck in a loop that you just can't break. We'll talk about craving cycles, emotional triggers, and how to loosen habits' grip when it feels like it's running the show. For now, I encourage you to start observing your own habits, not with frustration, but with curiosity. Pay attention to the cues, the routines, and the rewards that you experience in everyday moments. And that awareness is the first step to change. Thanks for watching today. I'll see you in the next video.